Hello, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Danielle Weigel once again, and we are going to be completing part two of the Transport to exam. As I mentioned before, we are going to be performing or simulating an experiment that will allow us to determine the relationship between the three dimensionless variables that we calculated before. So we have, I have the collaboratory screen pulled up here with Python, and then I also have this way with OBS. I have the manual set up so that anybody watching, my perspective is flipped, anybody watching can see the formatting that we're using, and then I also have the problem pulled up so that we can keep an idea of the overview of the broad picture of what we're trying to do. Before we do anything, we have to import all of the tools that we are going to be using in our code, and so that will be support for the arrays. We are going to end up graphing our data and the trend line, and then we also have like another function that is within a library that we have to import. So the first thing that we have to import to support our arrays and matrices is NumPy. So we will import that. And then for our graphing things, we first need to import the ability to make a graph. So that is from Plotly. I can spell correctly. And then we also need to import the ability to add our data into the subplot. So we have to import that as well. And then we also want to, if we want to change our template or how our graphs are going to look, we can also import that. And so that is the Plotly IO command. And then we can go ahead and change our template. I like dark backgrounds, so that's what we're going to use. So we build this array. Then we need to build a size for the array, so we don't really need to input anything like that. And with that, we will generate our experimental data. The next thing that we're going to have to do is, as a script, it's right here, we want to matrices, we'll have to be able to do the reciprocal of our matrices, and that's how we're going to set up our equations. This will be log number again, and then that should give us our correct array.
Section in the limit of those parameters, which is
what the original parameters are supposed to be, and that is R.023, and then R.83 and 0.44. Assign a marker size. Let's just go with 2 right now, and if we don't like it, we can always change it later. And then let's also add a fun little color spectrum. Spaced points in an array for the Reynolds number, which is 2,000 and 35,000. And we will also give that 20 points. And so then we also need to define do that, we will be using our for function. We'll pick three arbitrary values. I'm going to use M, N, and O. And then we are going to be zipping them. And then we want each line mesh grid onto the figure. So we're going to do fig add trace again, and this time we are going to be adding them as lines. We have to use our scatterplot 3D again, and then we will set x equal to m. Titles. We use dict is gonna like Sure. And then, if we want to turn off the legend, we can go with parentheses. Just go ahead and change the legend. Simulates how you would be solving the relationship between those three variables.